Namaste, I'm Dr. Divya Sitlani. I'm basically a homeopath and also a diabetic educator. So we are having this series. It's in six parts. And today we'll get started with the first part of diabetic camp kind of a thing. Diabetic awareness, diabetes management, breaking the myths about diabetes. And we'll see how we can go about it. It's basically a diabetes camp. And we will be trying to understand as well as manage diabetes. So this is my favorite slide. Knowledge is power, information is ammunition, and awareness is enlightenment. The ancient maxim, know thyself, applies to every facet of human existence, especially to one's health. The prevention, treatment, and management of illness and disease becomes easier and more effective when we are aware of the early symptoms of a medical condition, how to recognize it, and then how to go about getting the right kind of treatment. By this, what I mean to say is that we should be aware of our symptoms. We should be able to recognize our symptoms so that we can catch the disease in the first stage itself. And we can nip it in the bud stage and not allow it to catastrophize or to go on to the latter, you know, the fourth stage of any disease wherein the doctor says it is incurable. So we should not allow it to become like a snowball effect. But what I mean here is that please do not self-diagnose. Please do not self-investigate. Please do not self-medicate also. Consult a doctor, consult an MD doctor, and then see what he has to do. But my aim with these camps is that you get to know something much more about your body. Okay? Because it really helps you in that. Recognizing your symptoms. So now there are a lot of myths, you know, we are really confused about diabetes. So let's see how much we can do justice to it. Okay. So first of all, what we have to understand that there is something known as a truncal obesity. Now, what is truncal obesity? When the abdominal girth increases, okay? When you have a lot of accumulation of fat on your abdominal region or the core, okay? Now, this is a matter of concern. You know, we really joke sometimes that, you know, it's a sign of prosperity, you know, the tummy, Ganesha tummy. But certainly it's a risk of metabolic disorders. Maybe in the third or fourth class, we will understand metabolic disorders too. So let us see how we need to measure the waist circumference. Now, this is not exactly the waist where your tailor measures you. You know, your waist, that's not your waist here in this measurement. What we have to do is we have to stand up straight and we have to exhale, okay? Release the existing air, wrap a tape measure just above your hip bones. Now, what are those hip bones? They are the bony prominences at either side of your, a little above the pelvic region. Okay, they are also known as the hip bones or the pelvic bones. And there, those bony prominences, you need to place the measure tape over there and you measure your waist circumference out there. So hold the tape measure flat against the body, not very too tight, not too tight, and then take a reading. So that is your waist measurement in inches. Okay. So this is the waist, stand upright and on your hip bones, those bony prominences, not very tight, not very loose. Now, what are the readings which you should be concerned about? Now, waist measurement recommendations. The Centers for the Disease Control and Prevention warns us that exceeding the following waist circumference can increase the risk of developing obesity-related conditions. So for men, if your waist circumference increases beyond 40 inches, then it is a matter of cause, concern, and worry. Whereas in females, in women, in non-pregnant women, okay? In non-pregnant women, if the waist circumference is much more than 35 inches, it is certainly a cause of concern and we need to take or adopt some practices to get it within these ranges, right? So first of all, we have to understand the waist measurement recommendations, right? So this is something very clear. Now, there is something which is known as pre-diabetes, okay? Pre-diabetes. So, this line across your neck, you may be seeing it in a few people and you may be feeling this person is not a very fastidious and not a very clean person. She does not scrub her neck well. But my dear friends, it's not a matter of hygiene or cleanliness. This is something which is known as acanthosis nigra. Nigra means anything black. Okay. So acanthosis nigra, if it is seen around your neck region, it is a cause of concern because this is a diagnostic tool for diabetes. Okay, this is pre-diabetic symptoms I'm teaching you. Two more symptoms about it. So very clear, this is acanthosis nigra, which can be seen at the fold of your neck. The second, it looks something like this. See, you may feel the person is not cleaning the neck. No, but these are actually pre-diabetic symptoms. Now, these, many people, call these warts, but my dear friends, they are not warts. Warts are something very, 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 very different. These in particularly are known as skin tags. What are skin tags? Suppose you lose a lot of weight, or from thin you become fat, or from fat you become thin, you get these skin tags. Okay. So they may be around the neck region, they may be around your chest region, abdominal region, but around the neck region, if they are there, these skin tags also represent symptoms of pre-diabetes. Okay. So the disease does just not just wake up one night and then, you're diagnosed as diabetes. No, all these signs and symptoms come earlier. This is my main aim, to educate you that these are signs of pre-diabetes. So be aware, if you are getting these skin tags, you may land up into diabetes. You may not also, but then these are diagnostic tools of pre-diabetes. Okay, now there is darkening of the skin of your armpits, as well as darkening of the skin of your groins. This is the third symptom of pre-diabetes. Okay. Darkening of the skin of your armpits as well as your groin region. So these three symptoms are known, as I'm referring to them as pre-diabetes, but they are also known as insulin resistance. We will not take up insulin resistance. As we learn further and further, I will introduce you to insulin resistance concept also. But for now, we need to understand that you should learn to measure your waist circumference, from where you should be learning something about the pre-diabetes or insulin resistance. So you may be having a lot of, you may be feeling very, very bad that your armpits are like this, and you may be using the best of deos and the best of body washes. But then this is all futile, because it is something as an internal disorder, and it is insulin resistance. So today we stop here, and we'll take the next class tomorrow. Thank you.
Help Talks are daily health-related talks held at Health Education Library for People, Mumbai, India. For more information, visit www.healthlibrary.com. Subscribe to Help Talks channel. Be better informed about your health.